Hi everyone and welcome to MathSux. This video is going to help you pass algebra. In this video we're going to look at arithmetic sequences by looking at the formula, solving some quick examples, and then trying a harder word problem at the end of this video. So arithmetic sequences are a sequence that forms when the same number is added or subtracted to each term. So if we look at this example here, we have this sequence of numbers 4, 6, 8, 10. And if you notice the pattern that forms with these numbers, we're just adding 2 to each number. 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8. 8 plus 2 is 10. And if we were to keep going, the next term here would be 12, right? Because 10 plus 2 would just be 12. And the pattern could keep continuing. We could go 14, add 2. 16, etc. So these are the first couple terms. This is like our first term, our second term, our third term. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 7 terms here that we found. But what if we wanted to know the 123rd term? How would we find that? So that's where the arithmetic sequence formula comes in. The arithmetic sequence formula would be able to tell us, without us solving each term up to the 123rd term, it would tell us what that would be. So just to break down what the arithmetic sequence formula is, because there's a lot of different funky looking terms here. So let's just break down what each of these represent. So this just means a sub n. That's how this is pronounced, a sub n. And what this is the term we're trying to find. So what is the 123rd term? What's the value of that term? This will give us the answer. So the answer we're trying to find. So our next term here, a sub 1. So it just means the first term. So the first term in our sequence. So in the example we just looked at, the first term here is just 4. So just going with that same example. So the next thing is n. So this is the term number that we're trying to find within the sequence. We wanted to find the 123rd term. So this is really 123 in this case. And the last part is d, the common difference, which is significant for arithmetic sequences only. So let's write out common difference. And this just means the number we're adding or subtracting to each term within the sequence. So in this case, we're adding 2 to each number in the sequence. So in this case, this is just 2. So now that we know what the arithmetic sequence formula is, let's look back at our example, that sequence we were given, 4, 6, 8, 10, and we want to find the 123rd term. So to do that, we're just going to fill in our formula with the values we found. So let's write out our formula again. A sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So now let's just fill it in with what we know. So we're trying to find this, so that we're going to leave this blank. The first term is 4. We're trying to find the 123rd term, which is 123 minus 1, and then the times the common difference, which is 2, because we're always adding 2 in this sequence here. So remember, this is plus 2 plus 2. So we're going to put 2 here. And now we just need to find out what this all is. So 4 plus, always want to do the parentheses first, 122 times 2 equals 4 plus 122 times 2 is just 244. And then now we're just going to add these together and we get 248. So we know that a sub n is equal to 248. It is the 123rd term of this sequence. So let's try another one. Another quick example that's pretty similar. So given the following sequence, find the 12th term of 197, 94, 91. So the first thing you're going to want to do is find out what the pattern is. So what is a pattern going on between these numbers. So if you look, we're actually subtracting this time. And we're subtracting by 3. 100 minus 3 gives us 97. So if you're never sure about the pattern, you can always just play around with numbers in your calculator and see the relationship between these numbers. 97 minus 94, again minus 3. 94 minus 91 minus 3. So we want to find the 12th term. So this time we could actually find out doing it the long way. Right, this is our first term. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4. We could do 12 terms, but let's use the formula because we want to really practice that. So let's write out the formula. A sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So let's just get out the our formula, what each thing represents. So a sub 1 is just that first term. So in this case, our first term is now 100 plus n minus 1. So remember, n is the term that is the term number we're trying to find. So the term number we want to find is 12, because we want to find the 12th term. So it's 12 minus 1. And then d is that common difference, that number you're adding or subtracting by. So this time, that's minus 3. So notice that this common difference this time is a negative value, because we're subtracting. And now we're just going to solve as normal. So this is equal to 100 plus 11 times negative 3. This is equal to 111 times negative 3 will just give us minus 33. 100 minus 33 will just give us 67. So a sub n is equal to 67. So that means the 12th term of this sequence is 67. This is a little different. We have a word problem this time. It says Marge keeps adding friends to her social networking account. She began with only 4 friends, and then each subsequent week had 22, 40, 58, and then 76 friends. If the pattern continues, how many friends will she have after 9 weeks? So Marge is very popular, and she starts with 4 friends, and then has 22, 40. So I'm just taking everything from right here. 4 friends, and then this pattern here, 22, 40, 58, and 76. So the first thing we're going to want to do is look for the pattern. So how are these numbers related to each other? 4 plus 18 is 22. And let's see if this pattern continues. 22 plus 18 equals 40. And 40 plus 18 equals 58. And 58 plus 18 equals 76. So we have our common difference right away. So let's write out our formula. A sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So we have our common difference. So let's just write everything out again. Common difference, what you're adding or subtracting by each term, which is 18. N is the term you're trying to find, which is 9. They want to know after 9 weeks. So term trying to find, which in this case is 9. And the last part, part of our formula we need to fill in is the first term. So the first term of the sequence, which is given to us, which is just 4. So now we just need to plug in our numbers and solve. So this is equal to 4 plus 9 minus 1 times 18. Which equals 4 plus 8 times 18, which equals 4 plus 144, which just equals 148. And that's our answer. So it's solved the same exact way. Be aware of what a question is saying and how to line up the different numbers in the sequence. And if you're looking for more, check out the practice questions right here. The answers are up on my website, mathsux.org, if you want to check those out. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Happy calculating. Need more practice? Check out MathSux.org for more questions. Link below. Also, don't forget to subscribe. Happy calculating!